Max, thank you so much. Back to what we were talking about at the very beginning of the show. Residents here in Bryan are now seeing the results of a $132 million bond that was passed about 2 years ago. Well, now we're seeing some renovations that are happening at schools all over the Bryan School District. And literally, like, you can see the results of this.
You absolutely can see what's happening. That's exactly what I got to do all day today. I spent the afternoon with Bryan ISD Superintendent Dr. Tommy Wallace, who was more than happy to show off these changes and these upgrades. We are out here at Bryan High School, which looks a little bit different than it used to, and it's thanks to a bond that has pumped a lot of money into this school district. And all day today, we've been seeing the fruits of that money. Really, really some great renovations happening around the district that we've gotten a chance to look at. Let's start with Stephen F. Austin. What did we see out there today?
Well, today you saw the renovations of the gymnasium. You saw the renovations of the locker rooms and things of that nature. But then what you really saw was what's going to be our brand new Performing Arts Center, which is going to be open first performance November the 14th. Please put that on your calendar. And then what you also saw was the new construction that's going on, which is going to be the three-story academic wing. And it's on time. It's on budget. We're doing really good over there.
A lot of what you're doing, you keep mentioning repurposing, renovating things for different purposes. One of your specific examples is an old gym at SFA that's now being used for what?
Now, the old SFA gym has been renovated into the new SFA gym. And so now that there's another one that's in there that's going to be our new library. So we've taken an old SFA gymnasium and turned it into the library and multimedia room. And so we wanted to take the historical context of the old SFA and continue to use that in the new SFA. And so we're keeping that historic context at the same time.
And there is so much historical context there. Even just other folks on the tour today have said, I remember this decades ago, and this is what it looked like, and it's been so interesting to hear. Another thing about our tour with SFA is that there has clearly been a focus. You've renovated gym. There's a lot going on with athletics. But your arts program and your music program, what neat stuff. Tell me a little bit about what we saw.
You know, our fine arts program has just gotten better and better every year, and we're seeing more and more student enrollment and activities in our fine arts department. And so our orchestra has gotten much larger, and so now it's going to have a big, nice, state-of-the-art room for itself. And then you're going to have our band, which has just really grown at Stephen F. Austin, and across the district will have it'll be a new, brand new band hall, and that'll be opening next year. So our fine arts program is state-of-the-art, and now we have state-of-the-art facilities for our students and our teachers.
Very clearly, you have walls and walls of just these beautiful lockers of beautiful instruments, and you've got these great practice rooms and it just really, really neat facilities. And then you are completely renovating that auditorium, which I know you mentioned. So all this hard work, all this hard practice, you're going to be able to show it off so well. What's great about that auditorium?
You know, what's so great is that Performing Arts Center, we used to be the Bryan Civic Auditorium, and I think it started in 1966, I believe, and now it's been repurposed, refurbished, and it's going to look state-of-the-art. And of course, from 1966 now to 2016, it's really going to be neat to see those kids work in that nice band room, theater room, orchestra room, to come out and then perform on such a nice state-of-the-art stage.
Yeah, with a little bit of history. Now Bryan High School,
yes.
What's new here? We're right here in the Bistro.
Right, this is brand new. Our Career and Technology Department under David Reynolds has really just taken off, and with the new House Bill 4, with the new endorsements, we have a lot of students. In fact, the largest endorsement in Bryan ISD is the business endorsement, and so this really is a bistro now built where students learn how to cook, they learn how to serve, they learn how to run a restaurant. And so what you're in right now is actually a restaurant here at Bryan High School, where the students learn everything from putting in money for the ledgers, to the cooking, to the wait staff, every bit of it.
How interesting, in an industry that I don't think is usually addressed so much like that. Yes. in schools. And we've talked about fine arts and what you were using this bond money for, for the fine arts, but athletics, boy, Merrill Green Stadium, we didn't know it could get better, but then it did.
It did, and right now I will tell you that people who have played at Merrill Green Stadium now with the new addition of the press box have said this is one of the premier athletic facilities in the state of Texas. And we don't look at it from just a standpoint of just our coaches and our students, but we also look at it from an economic development standpoint. We receive a lot of bids for playoff games, but now with the addition of the press box, we'll get even more, which brings in business, brings people into the businesses, eats in our restaurants, stays in our hotels. So that is actually, all of our renovations are actually an economic development situation as well.
Sure, what a boon for the economy. Interesting stuff. And Ross Elementary, we mostly looked at middle school and high school so far, but Ross Elementary, some great renovations over there.
Well, Ross Elementary School was built years and years and years ago. I can't even remember when, but it's when the outdoor concept was really, it was an issue. Now today, the outdoor concept is not safe. It's not what you want, where people just walk in from the outside. So the old Sol Ross will be torn down, and the new that you saw today is going to be a two-story multi or a 21st century school. It's going to have a gifted and talented magnet in it for our elementary school students starting in 2017. So if your student qualifies for gifted and talented, it's going to be a gifted magnet. And so it's just state of the art, and it's going to have some great students graduate from there and move on. And I think we'll have more students that graduate with international baccalaureate degrees, national merit scholars. That's our focus.
Absolutely, and it all starts at the elementary level.
It starts at the foundation. In kindergarten.
Interesting. And then Bryan Collegiate High School, boy, you've mentioned this is a top 100 high school, and now it looks it.
It does. Bryan Collegiate High School, the past 3 years, has been a top 100 high school based on U.S. News and World Reports. And it's always done well, and brick and mortar doesn't make a school. The people do. But I will tell you that when the students come in and they saw the first day of school, they're top 100 high schools in the country, and it looks like a top 100 high school in the country. They were really excited, very fired up. The staff is excited. It just looks so clean, so crisp, and there's something about something new. And those kids really enjoy that school.
What a sense of pride for them.
Absolutely.
Lastly, let's talk about the folks who are funding these renovations. It's the people of the district. This is bond money that is coming out of the pockets of the people. What do you want to say to them, first for approving this, and second, about what they've done for these kids?
Well, first off, you have to shout out to all the people of the community that voted for the bond, and it passed 65-35. Wow. So, I mean, it was a huge bond. It was an overwhelming bond victory, and it's the people. The people in Bryan ISD said, the people of the community said, we want to fund new schools for our children. They deserve the best. It happened for our children. We want it for these children and for our grandchildren.
And now we're seeing a little bit of what it looks like, what all this money looks like for your community and for your students. Superintendent Dr. Tommy Wallace at Bryan ISD, thanks so much for chatting with us for a minute.
You bet.
Stick with us. We have a whole lot more First News at 4 coming up right after the break.